हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ गोविंद सर एंड टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू द आवर प्रीवियस टॉपिक दैट इज़ नेटवर्क थ्योरम एंड द नेक्स्ट थ्योरम इज़ सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द बेसिक KCL एंड KVLs, द मैश एनालिसिस, नोडल एनालिसिस एंड वी विल कंटिन्यू द नेक्स्ट थ्योरम दैट इज़ सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम। द सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम इज यूज टू फाइंड द सॉल्यूशन टू नेटवर्क विद टू और मोर सोर्सेज दैट आर नॉट इन सीरीज और पैरेलल। क्लियर? सो द करंट थ्रू और वोल्टेज अक्रॉस एन एलिमेंट इन अ लीनियर बाइलेटरल नेटवर्क इज इक्वल टू द एल्जेब्रिक सम ऑफ द करंट्स और वोल्टेजेस प्रोड्यूस्ड इंडिपेंडेंटली बाई ईच सोर्सेज। सो वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट, वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द करंट्स और वोल्टेजेस प्रोड्यूस्ड इंडिपेंडेंटली बाई ईच सोर्स। क्लियर? फॉर टू सोर्स नेटवर्क, इफ द करंट प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय वन सोर्स इज इन वन डायरेक्शन एंड वाइल द दैट प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय अदर इज इन अपोजिट डायरेक्शन थ्रू द सेम रजिस्टर, द रिजल्टिंग करंट इज द डिफरेंस ऑफ द टू एंड हैज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द लार्जर वन। सो द इम्पॉर्टेंट आस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ द सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम दैट इज इफ वी हैव टू नेटवर्क टू सोर्स नेटवर्क, if the current produced by one source is in one direction while the produced by the other is in opposite direction, then the algebraic sum or can say resulting current is the difference of the two and has the direction of larger current. Clear? If the individual currents are in the same direction and the resulting current is the sum of two, then the resulting current is the sum of two in the direction of either current. So these are the some aspects of to solving the superposition theorems. The total power delivered to the resistive element must be determined using the total current through or the total voltage across the element and cannot be determined by a single sum of the power levels established by each source. For applying superposition theorem, we have some steps. First one is replace all the independent voltage source with a short circuit, thereby eliminating difference at potential, that is V equals to zero. Internal independence of voltage source is zero. So first, to find out the response from for any one source, you have to replace all other sources, voltage sources, with a short circuit. Similarly, replace all other independent current sources with an open circuit, that is eliminating current I equals to zero. Internal impedance of ideal current source is infinite. That's why it is replaced by open circuit. So these are the assumptions for applying superposition theorem. Suppose we have an question or can say an example for superposition theorem in which we have two sources. First one is 120 volt source and second one is 12 ampere current source, and we have to find out the current in each branch, that is I1, I2 and I3 and I4. These are the finding currents in the branch. So first step is consider one source, either it will be current source, either it will be voltage source. Suppose we are considering first voltage source 120 volt, then we have to replace 12 ampere current source with their internal impedance, that is it will be open circuited. So the circuit will be looks like this. We have considered 120 volt and we mentioned the currents I1 dash, I2 dash, I3 dash and I4 dash in the same branches. Clear? So we can use nodal analysis or can say KCL at branch node where we assume the voltage is V1, then we find out the V1 value of V1. That is 30 volt by using the KCL method. Clear? If we have the value of V1, then we can find out the value of I1, I2 and I3 and I4. Clear? So we have the values of I1 dash, I2 dash, I3 dash and I4 dash for this circuit. Another way, another step is consider the second source, that is 12 ampere current source, and replace with the internal resistance of voltage source, that is zero. So we have replaced voltage source with short circuit. And now we mention the currents I1 double dash, I2 double dash, I3 double dash and I4 double dash in the same branches. These currents are produced by the current source 12 ampere. Now we can find out the currents in the branch. We can again use the KCL on the nodes. We have two nodes in the circuit. Then we have the equations for two nodes. Then we calculate the voltage of V3 and V4. Clear? And V3 is equals to minus 12 volt and V4 equals to minus 24 volt. Then we put the values in the equation of I1 in the form of I1 double dash, I2 double dash and I3 double dash, I4 double dash. Then we have the values of these currents which are produced by the current source 12 ampere. Clear? Now we have the algebraic sum of the different currents which are produced by the different voltage sources. First one is current source and voltage source. Then I1 equals to I1 dash plus I1 double dash. Similarly, I2 equals to I2 plus I2 double dash. But you have to mention the sign according to the direction of currents. So this is all about the superposition theorem, and we have found out the current in each branch of that network. Clear? So consider one source, eliminate others with their internal resistance. Now move to the next, that is Thevenin's theorem, very much an important theorem, that is Thevenin's theorem. Thevenin's theorems for linear electrical networks states that any combination of voltage sources, current sources and resistors with two terminal is electrically equivalent to a single voltage source and a single series resistor. So this is all about the statement of Thevenin's theorem. Any two terminal linear bilateral DC network can be replaced by an equivalent circuit consisting of voltage sources and series resistors. So this is a Thevenin equivalent circuit. There is a Thevenin voltage ETH and Thevenin resistor, that is RTH. So this is replaced voltage source VTS called Thevenin voltage, and the series resistor is called Thevenin resistors. So there are some steps to find out the Thevenin resistors and Thevenin voltage. So first you have to find out the Thevenin resistance, and for finding the value of Thevenin resistor, you have to replace all the other sources by their internal resistance. So the only resistors are remaining in the circuit, and just look from the load element and calculate the equivalent resistance of the network. That is the Thevenin resistance. So suppose we have this circuit, and we have to find out the current across RL, that is IL, or can say we have to calculate the Thevenin equivalent circuit from for the load RL. So just eliminate the voltage source from the circuit and look from the load side, and then calculate the equivalent resistance, that is R1 and R2 are in series, whereas R3 in parallel. So this equivalent resistance equal to the RTH, and the ETH will be calculate the voltage across the load point. Okay, so this is all replaced with this circuit, that is RTH and ETH, and this is all about the equivalent circuit of Thevenin equivalent circuit of the network. Okay, so this is the method of, this is the Thevenin equivalent theorem. Now have we have Norton's theorem. It is almost similar to the Thevenin theorem, but the difference is Norton's theorem for linear electrical network states that any collection of voltage sources, current sources and resistors with two terminals is electrically equivalent to an ideal current source. In this, we are replacing all the circuit with ideal current source and in parallel with a single resistance, whereas in the Thevenin theorem we are replacing the all the circuit with equivalent voltage source and in the series of single resistor. So this is also can be obtained in the Norton theorem. Now we have an important theorem, that is maximum power transfer theorem. The maximum power transfer theorem states that to obtain maximum external power from a source with a finite internal resistance, the resistance of the load must be equal to the resistance of the source as viewed from the output terminals. So as a load will receive maximum power from the linear bilateral DC network when the total resistor value is exactly equal to the Thevenin's resistance of the network. We know about the Thevenin resistance, how we calculate the Thevenin resistance. Just put all the sources, replace all the sources with their internal resistance and calculate the equivalent resistance from the load side, then we have the Thevenin resistance. For maximum power transfer theorem, the load resistance will be equal to the Thevenin resistance. Suppose we have a network, resistive network, which contains dependent and independent sources, but we have to transfer the maximum power, that is the value of VTH square upon 4 RTH, where is VTH is Thevenin voltage and RTH is Thevenin equivalent resistance. So we can calculate maximum power at the transfer, maximum power at the load side. Now we have some application of network theorem. Network theorem are useful in simplifying analysis of some circuits, but the more useful aspect of network theorem is the insight it provides into the properties and behavior of circuits. And another, network theorem also help in visualizing the response of complex networks. The superposition theorem find use in the study of alternating current circuits and the semiconductors circuit, whereas sometimes AC is often mixed with DC. So these are the some application, and this is all about the network theorem. So we have completed this topic of the first unit. We will move to the next in the next video of first unit. Thank you.